What an amazing moment that must have been for you when Michelle Obama read out the one word, Argo, and you realised that your story had just been made Best Picture at the Oscars. Tell me about how you felt in that moment.
It was beyond belief. An emotional reaction was amazing. Nothing I ever did in the service was as scary as that moment. But it also, it had the high as well as the low.
And Jonna, for you sitting there, you've obviously been through so much together, not just at the CIA, but in the sort of gestation period of this movie. It must have been a great emotional moment for the pair of you, wasn't it?
You know, it was 5 years pretty much from beginning to end. At the end, we cried when we won. We cried when Chris Terrio won. I think we cried the first time we saw the movie. And the whole thing has just been an emotional roller coaster, but a good one. Can't wait to see it again and see if we just keep crying. It was something. It was something. That was unexpected.
Matt Baglio, there's been lots of conjecture about how accurate the actual movie is in terms of history. What is your reaction to the reaction so far?
Well, you know, it's tough. It's a movie. I think people understand that. It's not a documentary. Hollywood movies tend to take liberty with the facts. There were some things that were omitted from the real story of Argo. One of the reasons why Tony and I wanted to write this book was because we wanted to get the real story out there. You know, I think the movie focuses more on Tony's side of events. Real life, the Canadians, of course, were instrumental in taking in the Americans when nobody else really would. That's also portrayed in the film. There are a couple of things that are different in real life, but on the whole, I think emotionally and the tone of the film, I think they did a pretty good job.